Do you ever wish that you could make people agree with you, like you, or remember you with a snap of your fingers? Believe it or not, it's actually possible. You just have to know a couple of tricks. Want to know all about them? Then keep watching. Before you find out how to always get what you want, be sure to hit subscribe and ring this notification bell to never miss a thing on the bright side of life. Here's tip number one. Mirror your opponent's body language to make them trust you. Body language is an important tool that can help you not only find out a person's secret feelings and desires, but also make them change their perception of you. You've probably heard that when someone secretly likes you, they mirror your body language with a little delay. Well, this rule works the other way around too. If you want someone to like and trust you, mirror their body language, especially their poses and gestures. The most important thing is to be smooth about it. For example, if they cross their arms, wait for about 30 to 60 seconds before doing the same thing. This trick is irreplaceable when making a great, long-lasting first impression, so go for it! Number 2. Use the word because to have it your way. During a heated discussion, every opinion has to be heard, but only one will be chosen as the final one. If you want it to be yours, simply use the word because with your reasoning. Back in 1978, Ellen Langer, a professor of psychology at Harvard, decided to test the true power of this word by conducting some very interesting research. The participants had to break in on a line of people who were waiting to use the copy machine. The first group had to say a trivial phrase. "Excuse me, I have 5 pages. May I use the Xerox machine?" The second group was able to provide a serious reason. "May I use the Xerox machine because I'm in a rush?" The final group of participants had a really lame excuse. "May I use the Xerox machine because I have to make copies?" Surprisingly, even this unconvincing excuse worked as 93% of people let the participants make copies. So, no matter how bizarre your reasoning is, using because can significantly increase your chances of getting a positive response. Because I said so, that's why. Number 3. Pause to give your words a bigger effect. Pausing at the right time can significantly increase the effect your speech has on others. But it's not the only thing that can make your words memorable. First of all, if possible, always try to use a calm but confident tone. This will help you establish yourself as a powerful and independent person. Don't talk too fast. It's subconsciously perceived as a sign of anxiety and weakness. Ooh. Talking way too slowly isn't a good idea either. It gives off a lazy and uninterested vibe. The volume of your voice makes a difference as well. A loud voice is often associated with obnoxiousness, and a quiet one with self-consciousness. Basically, your job is to keep it all perfectly in the middle and add pauses wisely. If you want your opponent to be on the edge of their seat, pause before an important comment. If you want them to remember what you said and really think about it, add a pause right after the statement. This simple trick will help you put all the right emphasis in your speech, making your opponent see the situation from your point of view. Number 4. Stay silent to find out more. If you want to get everything out of another person, you shouldn't insist or be too demanding about it. Simply stay silent and they'll tell you everything. When we are under too much pressure, we subconsciously rebel against it. But continuously getting no response creates a different kind of pressure, making us feel the need to explain ourselves and the situation in the tiniest detail. And that's the key to finding out everything without doing anything. Just don't forget to maintain eye contact with your opponent. Number 5. Be the first or last one to make them remember you. Psychologists confirm that we usually remember the beginning and end of an event the best. The middle part quickly turns into a blur. If you're doing an important interview, try to arrange things so that you'll be the first or last person seen. This can make you stand out without doing anything special, giving you the upper hand. However, This doesn't mean that you can put in zero effort and come away a winner. They will remember you, sure, but their image of you will depend only on your behavior and attitude. Number 6. Sit next to your opponent to receive less criticism. Let's say you know that your colleague or boss plans to lash out about your work skills in an upcoming meeting. How can you prevent a total disaster? Easy. Sit right next to them. This close proximity and the similar directions of your bodies will make them feel less comfortable with openly criticizing you. After all, it's always easier to take a jab at somebody who's far away from you, right? This trick will definitely work in your favor and make them go way easier on you than they had planned. Number 7. Ask someone for a favor to change their perception of you. This psychological trick is also known as the Benjamin Franklin effect and is based on a real story. Apparently, Benjamin Franklin really wanted to change a man's opinion of him, and he found an interesting way to do it. He asked the man to lend him a rare book and thanked him graciously when he received it. This little connection that Franklin built turned into a full-fledged friendship. In 1971, the psychologists John Schopler and John Comper decided to test this effect again and conducted a study of their own. The results showed that a person's conduct towards you basically shapes their perception of you. So, if they're kind to you, which is definitely the pattern when they do you a favor, they start to like you more because their actions make them like themselves. So, there you go. There's another secret weapon for you. Number 8. Use contrasts to get what you want. One of the most popular psychological manipulation techniques is to ask for something way bigger than what you really want. Of course, you'll get a no way answer, but don't worry, that's exactly the moment to start bargaining. Offer a slightly smaller, but still big option, and then slowly come down to exactly what you want. In contrast with all the options you mentioned before, your actual wish will not sound like a big deal, which can certainly help you make it a reality. Number 9. Nod slightly to make someone agree with you. Sometimes, the only thing you want in a discussion is to get someone to say yes or agree with you. Not a problem. To get the positive response you need, nod slightly while asking the question. Remember to maintain eye contact with your opponent. Their brain will subconsciously perceive your nodding as a sign that you agree with them, which will provoke the social pattern of nodding back, giving you the answer you actually want. But don't overdo it, as obvious nodding will get you nothing. Number 10. Draw a triangle with your eyes to stop a conversation. Have you ever been in the company of someone who talks and talks and talks? You're already over it and want to go home, but you can't stop the conversation because you don't want to be rude. The truth is, you don't have to. Your eyes can do the talking for you. Look at your opponent in one eye, then in the other, and then at their forehead. Keep drawing this triangle shape for the rest of the conversation. They'll soon get the message on the subconscious level and say their goodbyes. A perfect life hack for awkward encounters. So, do you know any other psychological tricks for reading people? Tell us in the comment section below. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe. Stay on the bright side.